Only at the Indianapolis
Zoo. So we have four reticulated giraffe here. We have one adult male. This is Majani. He is 9 years old. And then we have another adult female, AJ. She is 21. She is typically the giraffe you're gonna feed at our public platform. And then we have two younger ones there. We have Kita, who will be 3 in August. And then our youngest, Makena, she just turned a year old. Giraffes, believe it or not, are declining in numbers steadily. They have been labeled the silent threatened species, just loss of habitat, and then poaching, just like any other species of wildlife. These guys are very skittish, believe it or not. They're kind of creatures of habit, so there's only about 4 of us that routinely work this area, primarily for that reason. Everything needs to be very consistent. They go out a certain way, they come in a certain way, they're fed a certain way. And it's just their trust factors. They're a little uneasy of strangers and new things. But if someone comes in with like a really bright shirt or pants on, sometimes that'll make them standoffish a bit. They are one of the few animals that have full spectrum of the rainbow, so they can see all colors. Each neck is typically 5 to 6 feet, depending on the individual. Height-wise, our male Majani there is about 17 feet tall. Our females, primarily AJ here, is about 14 feet. So there is a size difference between the sexes. You are going to have your kind of matriarch female. So they could have large groups. So you may see just a family unit, maybe 3 to 5 individuals, and you could see up to 30 to 40 giraffe in a herd. It just depends on the location. And you will see them around other antelope, maybe smaller gazelle species. They are a ruminant, so that means they have a 4-chambered stomach. So a cool thing about their feces, it is so small, they're almost like little milk duds. They don't drink a whole lot. It's a vulnerable position for them to be in, especially in the wild when you are having to spread those front legs and go all the way down and yet trying to look for predators. That can be a scary thing for them. And in the wild, they would be eating primarily leaves. So primarily that would be acacia leaves. And that's actually impressive. The acacia trees are very thorny, and that is why their tongues are pretty rough feeling. The tongue would need to be rough so it doesn't splinter or cut the tongue when they're grabbing the branches and then pulling the leaves off of the branch. The tongues are black or kind of a dark gray on the first portion of it. The theory is so it doesn't get sunburned, which completely makes sense. If you were out in the wild and had your tongue sticking out and eating from trees for hours endlessly, you wouldn't want your precious tongue to get sunburned. Thank you guys for tuning in to meet our giraffe herd. We hope to see you guys very soon, and they will be excited to see you at the public platform.